فالفرش التراب يضمني وهو غطائي.
I often give this example with this. You know what the dunya is like? When Allah says it's mata'ul ghurur, goods of deception. It's like a person who's having, he's asleep and he has a dream. You know, have you ever had a dream? Yeah? You have a dream and you're getting battered in that dream. You actually feel the pain. You're going like this in your dream. But when you wake up, you realize it was only a dream. You realize it's only a dream. You know, you have a dream that subhanAllah, you live in Mayfair, you got a flat in Mayfair. You're having this dream. And then whilst you're living in Mayfair, you open the curtains and you look down and you see your Ferrari. And it's like smile upon smile. And then you look around and subhanAllah, you see your partner. Most impeccable partner, impeccable character, and you get elated. You're happy. You, when you in that dream, you actually feel. You actually feel that that is happening to you. But then you open your eyes and you realize that that was just a dream. You open your eyes, you realize that was a dream. You go out downstairs and you realize you're still living in Aldgate. You jump out your front door and you see your bicycle. And then that impeccable character, that impeccable wife that you're looking for, you realize you're still single. You're going to go bed alone tonight. But for that period, when you are having that dream, you believe it's real. By Allah, this is why Ali radiallahu anhu said, people are sleeping. Only when they die will they realize the fallacy of the dunya. Only when you die will your eyes really open. You know, yesterday there was a plane crash in Pakistan. I think 127 people died. There's millions of people in Pakistan. And subhanAllah, one of my teachers out of those million happened to be on that plane. But we think it's never going to happen to us. We think that we are going to see that tomorrow. By Allah, there's no guarantee that you are going to see tomorrow. There are two tomorrows. There is one tomorrow of this dunya. There is no guarantee that you are going to see it. And there is the tomorrow of the hereafter. I swear by Allah, there is no doubt that you are going to see it. There is no doubt that you are going to see it. And the only thing that will count when you would leave this dunya is what actions did you do? How did you serve Allah? Were you true servant to Allah? When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَالْآدِيَاتِ ضَبْحًا وَالْمُورِيَاتِ قَدْحًا وَالْمُغِيرَاتِ سُبْحًا فَأَثَرْنَا بِهِ نَقْعًا فَوَسَطْنَا بِهِ جَمْعًا إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لِرَبِّهِ لَكَنُودٍ. Allah takes the oath by what? Those horses which fight in jihad. He said, by those horses when they run, they pant. And they run with so much vigor that they make sparks. And then they attack the enemy in the morning. And then Allah says, فَأَثَرْنَا بِهِ نَقْعًا فَوَسَطْنَا بِهِ جَمْعًا. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لِرَبِّهِ لَكَنُودٍ. And when they run, they make dust fly up. And when they attack their enemy, they attack right in the middle. But man unto his Lord is ungrateful. Why does Allah say this? Why does Allah give the example of horses and then says man is ungrateful to his Lord? Because see, a horse, the master gives it some fodder. It gives it some food. And that horse is ready to die for its master. And Allah created us. Allah brought us into existence when we did not exist. And we look at our state. Look at our state. Somebody come to our house. Yeah, and he's got bad manners. And we don't like the guy. You know, what do we think? We think, you know what? Can't wait till this guy leave. He's in my house. How can he behave in that manner? That's what we think. You know, it's my house. Do what he wants in his house. But my house, he abides by my laws. But then are we hypocrites? That we walk on the earth of Allah and we transgress his laws day and night. We eat the sustenance that Allah gives us and we gain the energy only to transgress His laws. We spend the lives that Allah gives us in deluding ourselves. Why? Because we make the dunya our maqsad and we forget our purpose in life.
والنور خط كتاب